Ben and Jenny are.
Okay, still to come this morning. We're going to be talking to music legend Neil Diamond, but first we're going to hear him perform one of his classic tracks. This is Cracklin Rosie.
Cracklin Rosie, get on board. We gonna ride till there ain't no more to go. Taking it slow. Lord, don't you know? Had me a time with a poor man's lady, hitching on a twilight train. Ain't nothing here that I can't take along. Maybe a song to sing when I want. Don't need to say please to no man or a happy tear. For love, my rosy child, you got the way to make me happy. You and me, we go in style. Cracklin Rose, your star-bought woman, make me sing like a guitar man. Hang on to me, girl, our song keeps running on. Yeah. Play it now, play it now, play it now, my lady. Rosie, make me a smile. God, if it lasts for an hour, well, that's all right. We got all night. Set this world right. Find us a dream that don't ask no questions. Yeah. Oh, well, love my rosy child. You got the way to make me happy. You and me, we go style. Cracklin Rosie, your star-bought woman, make me sing like a guitar man. Hang on to me, girl, our song keeps running on. Yeah. Play it now, play it now, my lady. Cracklin Rosie, make me a smile. God, if it lasts for an hour, well, that's all right. We got all night. Set this world right. Find us a dream that don't ask no questions. Yeah. Yeah. Oh yes. Oh yes.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
Brilliant. Well, we're going to chat to Neil in a couple of minutes' time.
That's after. We've got a new gardening guru, Sven Wong.
Hi there. Now, we saw him performing one of his classics a little earlier. The one and only Neil Diamond is with us again. Good to see you this morning.
Thank you very much.
How are you feeling? Singing live at that hour of the day.
It's rough. You know, I was thinking about that. You know, if you were an athlete, you would at least warm up and you'd... It'd be tough to put your peak performance in at 8 in the morning, but...
You're sounding okay. I think you may have done it once or twice.
Thank you. I was surprised myself. There was a voice there. I had no idea at this hour.
Now, listen, last time you popped in, you were talking about going off on a tour of the UK.
Yeah.
And now it's literally about to happen. What, week, 2 weeks away?
We start next week in Sheffield.
Good for you. Now, are you looking forward to that? Is it still thrilling, or is it a bit, oh, gosh,
not sleeping in my own bed?
Do you quite
thrilling.
Like doing...
It's thrilling. It's... You know, you want to do it at this point. I've talked about it enough. It's time to do it. So I'm happy that we're here and ready to do it.
Great stuff. What are we like as an audience, the British? Are we a bit reserved? Are we different from the Americans?
Strange.
Are we?
No, actually, you know, the audiences are fabulous. And if I close my eyes, I couldn't tell the difference between the audiences here or in New York or in Sydney, Australia. It just seems to be, you know, my audience, and they like what's happening, and we try and give them everything they want.
Fantastic. Well, they all love you. I think you've got a huge fan base, haven't you? The people that are desperate to come and see you play. So it all started when you were 16, when someone gave you a guitar as a birthday present. That was a good present, wasn't it, back then?
It turned out to be a good present. I'd always been involved and loved music, but when I started... taking guitar lessons and then piano lessons, I really started to know a little bit about it, not just singing along with the radio. And So it was a start for me, really, and I pretty soon I got hooked on writing songs, and that was it. I've been doing it since.
Because you almost became a doctor.
Well, right? Yes, almost in the sense that I studied pre-med at New York University, but no, I had my heart set on writing, and that was all I could think about. So I had no chance, really, to graduate pre-med or even go to med school.
You just thought, right, I'm going to go for this. And I think it probably wasn't a bad decision, was it? Looking back
now
after four decades.
Yeah, now it looks like a pretty good decision. Back then, it was the stupidest thing I'd ever done.
I can imagine your family must have thought you were mad.
Well, they knew that I was in love with writing, and they accepted it, and they went along with it, probably thinking that I'd get back to my real business at hand at some point, but I never did.
Give you a chance. See, it's funny because we've got American Idol, of course, over in the States. We've got Pop Idol here, and we see so many youngsters coming on from that show, and also just generally musicians and pop artists all wide-eyed and excited with their first hit.
Well,
and
you
know,
be.
Sadly, sometimes you don't see them again. Why do you think you lasted, and what did you have that kept you going that perhaps these other youngsters don't have?
Luck.
Is it just that, do you think?
Well, I mean, everybody, the people who come into this business are willing to work hard. It requires a modicum of musical talent. But luck plays a very important part of it, you know. So this Idol show is one of the lucky breaks that you can get, you know.
But then you have to do something with it, I guess.
Yeah. And as far as I can see, these kids are ready to work hard. The only unfortunate thing I see about it is that they're not taking the usual route, which is to start at the bottom and work your way up and learn and do all that kind of thing. You know, they audition, and if they're liked by the producers, they're on, you know, national television, and if they win, they're stars. So I kind of like the idea of people working their way up and paying their dues.
You had time to grow, and you're still growing.
Yes. Starting
good
in Sheffield.
And then dates all over the country.
Right.
Brilliant.
Some, yeah.
All right, well, we look forward to seeing you, and hearing you sing this morning was great. Thanks very much indeed.
Thank you. Thank you.
Just a modicum of talent.
A modicum of talent that has sold 115 million albums worldwide.
Yeah,
have a great
exactly.
That's the luck part.
We all need just a little bit of that. Find out about Neil's tour dates on our website, gm.tv. And that is about us for the week.
It is indeed.
Have a great weekend.
Yeah, absolutely. Have yourself a lovely time. Here are Ben and Jenny.